Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to discuss the following question, which says that prove that cos inverse of 7 by 18 plus sin inverse of 6 by 10 is equal to cos inverse of 28 minus 3 into square root of 315 by 90. We know that cos inverse of x plus cos inverse of y is equal to cos inverse of xy minus square root of 1 minus x square into square root of 1 minus y square. If both x and y are greater than 0 and x square plus y square is less than equal to 1, with this key idea, we shall move on to the solution. We need to prove that cos inverse of 7 by 18 plus sin inverse of 6 by 10 is equal to cos inverse of 28 minus 3 into square root of 315 whole upon 90. Taking the left hand side of the expression, we have cos inverse of 7 by 18 plus sin inverse of 6 by 10. Now we shall convert sin inverse of 6 by 10 in terms of cos inverse function. Let theta be equal to sin inverse of 6 by 10, which implies that sin of theta is equal to 6 by 10. In a triangle ABC, if theta is the angle between the lines AC and CB, we know that sin of theta is given by perpendicular upon hypotenuse, that is AB upon AC, which will be equal to 6 by 10. That is, if we have the value of the perpendicular AB as 6 and the value of the hypotenuse AC as 10, then we can find the value of the base CB by using the Pythagoras theorem. By Pythagoras theorem, we have base BC is equal to square root of hypotenuse AC square minus perpendicular AB square, that is equal to square root of 10 square minus 6 square, which is given by square root of 100 minus 36, that is equal to square root of 64, which is given by 8. So base BC is equal to 8. Now we know that cos of theta is equal to base upon hypotenuse, that is BC upon AC, which is equal to 8 by 10, which implies that theta is equal to cos inverse of 8 by 10. So here we have sin inverse of 6 by 10 as theta, and theta is equal to cos inverse of 8 by 10, which implies that sin inverse of 6 by 10 is equal to cos inverse of 8 by 10. So we can replace sin inverse of 6 by 10 with cos inverse of 8 by 10 in the left hand side of the given expression. Therefore, the left hand side becomes cos inverse of 7 by 18 plus cos inverse of 8 by 10. Now from the key idea, we have cos inverse of x plus cos inverse of y is equal to cos inverse of xy minus square root of 1 minus x square into square root of 1 minus y square, provided both x and y are greater than 0 and x square plus y square is less than equal to 1. Here we assume x as 7 by 18 and y as 8 by 10, and we have 7 by 18 is greater than 0 and 8 by 10 is greater than 0. Also, 7 by 18 square plus 8 by 10 square is less than 1. Therefore, we can write the value of the expression cos inverse of 7 by 18 plus cos inverse of 8 by 10 is equal to cos inverse of 7 by 18 into 8 by 10 minus square root of 1 minus 7 by 18 square into square root of 1 minus 8 by 10 square, which is equal to cos inverse of 14 upon 45 minus square root of 1 minus 49 upon 364 into square root of 1 minus 64 by 100, which further gives cos inverse of 14 by 45 minus square root of 364 minus 49 upon 364 into square root of 100 minus 64 by 100, which is equal to cos inverse of 14 by 45 minus square root of 315 by 364 into square root of 36 by 100, which is equal to cos inverse of 14 by 45 minus square root of 315 by 18 into 6 by 10, which on further solving gives cos inverse of 14 by 45 minus square root of 315 by 30. Now, on taking the LCM within the bracket, we get cos inverse of 28 minus 3 into square root of 315 by 90. So we have cos inverse of 7 by 18 plus cos inverse of 8 by 10 is equal to cos inverse of 28 minus 3 into square root of 315 by 90. Or we can also write it as cos inverse of 7 by 18 plus sin inverse of 6 by 10 is equal to cos inverse of 28 minus 3 into square root of 315 by 90, which is equal to the right hand side. Hence we have proved our result, that is cos inverse of 7 by 18 plus sin inverse of 6 by 10 is equal to cos inverse of 28 minus 3 square root of 315 by 90. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.